I am Sister Teresita Powath. I joined this congregation. My congregation is the Congregation of Jesus. It is an international congregation. I joined in 1969, soon after my SLC. I joined and then we came to Allahabad. That was our novitiate was there in those days. So I had my novitiate and the initial training in the congregation. And I did, along with that, of course, I did my inter and BSc.
Okay.
After my final vows in 1979, I went to St. John's and then came back to Bihar, worked here for 4 years, then went back to St. John's and joined the first batch of MD Gyne there when we got the post graduation. So, completed that and came back in 92. I mean, my intention was to work for the poor in a social work or like something of that sort. But then the medical line was more needed, then I realized I can serve better. So I was happy. I was very happy to go for that, yes. Purana Bhojpur is the name of the village. The Dumrav is the block, our block. Okay, it's close by. It's actually very close. That's why most of us refer to as Dumrav. Mm. It is in Buxar district in the state of Bihar. It is in the almost midway between Varanasi and Patna. See, Patna is about 125 kilometers from here. It is the capital of Bihar. Totally rural.
Okay.
And Dumrav is a little semi town, you can call it.
Okay.
That is a block headquarters. Actually, you know, Buxar is a small district derived from Bhojpur, divided from Bhojpur district, and it's a small place actually. Hmm. So, Dumrav, it's only got two or three blocks. See, from my childhood, already I had an inclination, okay. Then I used to read the life histories of, say, I am a good reader. Reading has been a habit from my childhood even now. So I used to read, of course, a lot of saints. Sisters used to give me the books like, you know, Life of Saints and all. So the Life of St. Francis Xavier and the Life of Little Flower. St. Teresa of Child Jesus. Life's influenced me a lot. Missionaries. For the great soul, and that's why I wanted to be a missionary. Okay. Otherwise, I would have joined in Kerala. That would have been. Sisters were calling me, you come here, you come, but I didn't want. I wanted to be a missionary. And so I had an inclination for it. Then, when I finished my SLC, I decided now is the time. Usually, those days it was after metric, people made a decision which way to go. So that time I chose this. Of course, my parents did not agree, but I somehow managed. Yes, I am the eldest of the family. Okay. Two younger brothers and two younger sisters. They would have preferred me to be at home. I was a good student, so they would have expected me to study and go ahead in life. And then I convinced them, I cried and I did not eat for a few days and all those things. Then of course my auntie was my father's sister. She was a teenager, so she convinced them that if she's wanting, then let her go. I had some relations in this congregation one day. So they had come home for holidays, so I liked them. I liked their dress and all those things, so that's all. I was not scared. I had a focus in my mind, what I wanted to be. So I was not scared. Of course, my parents were this thing, and it was told that we'll be coming back only after 5 or 6 years, and you will not see. And my grandparents were there; they were very upset. Well, yeah. I was there. See, that time, if you ask me the experience, it was a joy. We had about 8, 9 of us were there. Sisters were there. It was a picnic. Okay, well, also you felt you were homesick. Yes, you are first time being away from parents. The feelings were there, but then it was nice. Those sisters were very kind. So they tried to make us more comfortable as much as possible. It was a congregational requirement, actually. You see, ours is mainly catering for education. But in Bihar, we had ventured into health also. Three places now, like here, Numrao, and one or two more places we have health dispensaries we had. And the sisters were finding it difficult without a doctor. So they said we need doctors. So one or two sisters had attempted before, but they could not get through or whatever it was. So my superiors asked if I was interested. I mean, they asked me, of course. They would not, now congregation, we are not pushed into any ministry. It's our choice. So when I felt the need, I was happy, because I was not very happy to teach in them, because we are hi-fi schools and all, you know. In Allahabad, our school is very famous. Lucknow, Kanpur, all cities, we are big schools. I was not that very inclined for that. So when this offer was, I was very happy. So I chose that. So I said agreed, and then keeping in that mind, my information went on up. Now in the whole, we are now so many provinces. If you ask me, we are mainly in North India, that is in UP, or Uttarakhand, now of course in Delhi, Nepal we have, and then of course South also we have now, Bangalore, Bombay. 1853. Yes, we were the first congregation to start in Bihar. That time between Agra and Bombay and Calcutta, I think we were the ones starting the high school. Our sisters came from Germany, and they came by bullock cart from Bombay to Patna. Ours is an international congregation. So the German province started in India. Because of the bishops, I think our Patna bishop was a bishop from Switzerland. Yeah, they started a school for boarding school, only for girls. Okay. Education of girls was in priority, so for girls we started. Ours was the first school. Then they went to Allahabad, then Nainital, then Kanpur, like Jhansi, all these places. See, wherever the railway headquarters and things like that, you know, they went and established school. They didn't think of going into real remote villages, but because of safety, the world wars and all kinds of things were there, no? Yeah, it was always focus was on education of women and faith formation of women. That was the main focus of us. Now anybody who applies, let's say formerly they used to have these people going and all this. Now people apply for it. Once they are applied, they are language learning. See, when we came also, first 1 year we learned the language. Yeah, we had learned Hindi, we had learned English. Now here even dialects, we had learned Bhojpuri and all kinds of languages. It's beautiful. Bhojpuri is nice, very beautiful. After being, then we have this 1 year of postulancy, where we come to know about the congregation and things like that. Then we have the juniorate, and during this juniorate, we also get some amount of professional training, whichever way you want to, the beginning of that, you know, they channel you. If you want to be a teacher, you are trained in that line, or a nurse, or a social worker, then they go for BSW, MS. Now, see, proper training is given during those days. And we are, of course, given our own ministries, various. When we joined, and all, it was easy. It was just, not very long. Maximum for 2 years of novitiate and 1 year candidate, postulancy, 4 years. Yeah. But now, see, most of the children, they come, their language is poor, very poor. So they take more. See, we make it very sure that they are proficient in their language. Otherwise, they cannot understand the constitution. So it takes time. Okay. Some take 4 years. It depends on the individuals now. It's not a fixed that there are 2 years you become a novice or 4 years you make your vows now. Some people go on. And some of them we send for their professional studies now, even before the novitiate. So that, because the age factor also is there. There are various things.
Yes.
They learned very young. Now they come, they are sometimes 20, 21, 22. So it is, and they would have only finished their matric that time. Oh, very much. Absolutely.
Okay.
Everybody feels once in a way, no?
Yes.
Once in a way, all of us feel lonely. That is a normal thing.
Yes.
But as a sister, for us, it is the community is there to fall back when you feel lonely.
Yeah.
I have felt lonely, I don't say. Especially when I came from Bangalore to Bihar, it was a two-world. Those days I was really feeling very ill. Now I am adjusted to this place, no problem.
Yes.
Initially, you know.
Yes.
Yeah. Then you feel alone. Then there is the community to fall back, and you have friends to talk to. And if nothing else, I just can go out to the garden and look at the flowers and the butterflies. Then you
feel blue. Better.
The thing is gone. Plus, there is also some amount of loneliness which we all feel, which I feel can be only fulfilled by God. You know, it's a longing for God. So that experience, so go to the chapel, pray, and then you know you get it is. I don't call it loneliness. It is a longing, something. You get an experience of God's love, and that fills your heart, and then you are okay. See, if anyone would come to me, I would say, think nicely, discern the will of God, and if you feel in your heart, see what your heart is saying in front of God. Not the, because that one said or this one said. In front of God, what your heart is saying, and you feel you are convinced. Because we need committed people now also to continue this work. We need committed people, not mediocrity and numbers we don't need. Committed people. So if someone is there ready for that, I would encourage them. Definitely I would encourage them. Because the reward is great. How life you look at it, the way you look at it individually. Like for me now, I have lived only 15, 16 years in my home. Okay, the rest of it I have lived in my community, in the congregation. And I can tell you, I had a very fulfilling life, and I have enjoyed every bit of it. I have enjoyed it. I have enjoyed life. I don't have any regrets. Not enjoyed. I have had friends. I have had community experience. Like good and bad. Yes, I don't say everything was rosy, but. That even those, you know, you are able to enjoy when you look at it, why you have come here, and it was your choice. It was my choice. It was nobody else's choice. So you can look at it, somebody can say, oh, I have to obey every time, I am alone, and you can sit that way, and then it is nothing for you. But if you look, I have chosen this life, and I want to live this life, and I will live it to the fullest, then it
you
is happy life.
The fullest.
You enjoy. You should have enthusiasm. You should enjoy. Then it is good. It depends on what enjoyment you are meaning. You know, when I said I enjoy life, I mean I feel I'm happy. I have of course fun. We have fun. So we go for picnics. We play cards. We get games. All kinds. Or we have some recreations. Various recreations we have, organized recreation. We have TV also. We have TV. We can watch news. We want to watch a movie, you are free. You watch. Yeah. You can read. You can do gardening. Anything you want, you do. That's See, we are free to serve the poor people. In a very free way. We don't have any, here I am working here. I don't have to worry about name or fame, or I need more patients so that I get more money, like competition, nothing of that sort. I am provided for whatever my minimum needs are. It's absolutely. But then for service, I am here. I give the best service. I'm not doing it for money, and my patients know that. Okay, we need to think about our minimum sustenance and all that. That is there. Yeah. But you know, I don't have to be a competitive spirit. I need not have to have. Also, I need not worry about gathering money for the future for my children and their education and all those things. Plus, another thing is that, see, our primary thing is we are following Jesus, okay? Compassionate Jesus Christ, we are supposed to give to the people. Right. So that is another reason why we don't have to worry about all these things. See, we think of that part. I like to give to be another Christ, compassion of Jesus, healing of Jesus. That is what we are, our primary aim. So that is a different from a doctor outside who wants to shine in his field. Now I need not be the best obstetrician and gynecologist in the world. No need for me that. I always receive them with a smile. Okay? Because they are coming to me with the pain. Yes, they are coming. Yeah. So that is one thing. At the end, I talk to them nicely so that they feel that I care for them. That is one thing. Then at the end of most of my patients, especially my infertility patients, I tell them to pray. I say, I can only give you medicine. God who heals you. So I tell them, I pray for you and you also pray. And I have got great devotion to Mother Mary also. I tell them to pray to her so that you get a child, because she knows. So these things I talk to them. You see, when I talk to them, they are Hindus. They are mostly Hindus, not Christians, okay? Hardly any Christians come here. It's all Hindus who come here. Right. But we talk to them this way. I'm not telling them to be Christians or anything, but I tell them. And Mother Mary is, they are very fond, because for them it is Devi. They believe, they have a lot of faith. And they, you know, some patients, I can tell you one day, one patient came, we were preparing for Christmas. We were painting the gamal, you know, flower pots and all a little bit. Then she said, let me also do this. And by doing this, if God bless me with a child. And she had been married she was 35 years old. And she had gone to Bombay all over and come. And she sat there 2 hours and she did this painting of this flower pots with me. Prayed, put some candles and prayed under the grot of Our Lady and went. I didn't see her for 1 year. 1 year she came back with a child. See, these are things, you know, it increases their faith. Every year, that child's birthday, she comes here and prays to Our Lady and gives candles and offerings and goes back. So now that child must be some 11, 12 years old. So that is the difference. When I say, I am not telling them, preaching Christ to them, no. But this is the way I tell them to turn to God. Plenty of stories now. I have had a lot. I said with these old people. Another mine is old people, no? And we get good fun also. Sometimes you ask what Kaudava sister said. Nice fun from these old people. The first time when we had this, all the women were in the inside and the men were outside. Then the lady in the night calling out, old woman, must be in her 80s or 90s. Okay. Raja, tum kahan ho? Calling out for the all the staff and everybody come laughing away like anything, you know. So this kind of jokes we have. And then the other fellow coming, calling from out, I am here, don't worry. Oh, how they are bonded together, you must see. Yeah. This, you know, that gives me a lot. I grew up with the grandparents. So I have a lot of affection for old people. That is, But then, you know, like this things. And then yesterday when they came and blessed me, that was about 20 years ago. Okay. They blessed me saying that you have given us sight. You are our God. I said, I am not your God. Whoever is, and I showed the God to them. But you know, they bless me, and I each time I get a blessing from a patient.
Yes.
I feel really humbled and rewarded. Yes, both ways.